You're welcome to the linking the external data to drawing objects with AutoCAD Map3D exercise. I'm Vlado Melchenko. I will explain how to combine drawing objects with external tabular data in order to increase the value of all this data together and use them for creating some new GIS data. For the beginning, we have this map with red thick polylines for outlines of buildings, and this Excel file with data on each of these buildings. We'll attach this file to our map, but first we have to define a range of data we want to link to the objects on the map. For that, we'll select all cells with such data, click the Insert menu, go to Name, and click the Assign command. In the Assign Name dialog window, we'll enter some name for our new range, for instance building data, and click enter. We'll close the Excel file with saving all changes we made to it. Now we'll make sure that we have selected the Map Explorer tab on the task pane. Right click data sources and click the attach command. In the attach data source window, we'll navigate to our Excel file, select it, and click the Attach button. In the Select Database Version window, we'll select the Excel 97 version and click OK. And now in Task Pane, we see that we have attached this file to our map with the range we just created. We'll open this range, that we'll double click it, and thereby we have opened the data view window with all data from this range and tools to handle them. Now we can link each record in this table to an object on our map. We'll select the first record. But first we have to define a link template. For that we'll click the Define Link Template button and assign a key to one of columns or fields of our table and click OK. We see that some more buttons have become accessible. We'll click the Link Records button and select the corresponding object on our map and click Enter. It's easy to select these objects because the building addresses are written just on the map and they are contained in the build num field of the table. In this way, for example, I will link four more records to the objects. If we select any object with linked data, we can see this data just in the Properties window. We can use the Data View window to analyze the data. For instance, we want to see only data on the commercial properties. As it can be seen in the Purpose field. For that, we'll click the SQL filter button, and in the table filter window we'll select purpose in the column drop-down list, click this button near the value field, and we'll select commercial in the column values window and click OK. We'll click the add button and click OK. And so only data on the commercial buildings are now presented in our table. To clear the filter, it's enough to click the Clear Filter button. It's possible to filter the records on the basis of some spatial criteria, For that, we'll click the special filter button and select several objects on our map and click enter. And now we see that only records linked to these objects are presented in the table. We'll clear this filter. If we select some records, we can automatically select the objects these records are linked to. For that, we'll click the View Linked Objects button, and we see that these two objects have been selected. On the contrary, it is also possible to highlight the linked records when we have selected objects on the map. For that, we'll click the Highlight Linked Records button and we'll select several objects and click enter. And so we see that the three records are now highlighted. The main purpose of what we have done in this exercise is to prepare all the data to convert them to some JS format. And how to do this I will show in the creating a feature class from drawing objects with the linked data with AutoCAD Map 3D exercise. Thank you for your attention.